Hi, and welcome to a short tutorial on how to prepare and export your projects correctly via IFC from Autodesk Revit to the Gamma AR platform. Okay, so before we get started, there's a couple of prerequisites that we would like to talk about before diving into the correct export settings. As Gamma AR, as of yet, cannot depict 2D plan information, it is important to have the model at a sensible development stage before export. In order to later on be able to position the model in AR on site, it must contain at least one of the following elements: walls, which are generally the easiest, spaces, or columns. Using one of these elements is key to be able to utilize Gamma AR correctly. Even though the app doesn't have a file size limit, it does rely on the correct allocation of elements to the reference levels, especially on more complex, multi-level projects. So please make sure that all elements are referenced to the correct levels, not just for the sake of using Gamma AR. Lastly, if you have a very large project that isn't naturally partitioned, for example, by different levels, consider reducing the scope of what should be exported. We will get into that in the next step. Depending on your own workflow on site, you can prepare your model according to what suits your needs the best by creating custom views in Revit. Gamma AR is able not only to depict any 3D views easily, but also the planned phases as well. By exporting a prepared 3D view, you make certain that the app has 3D rooms to work with. As 3D views can be completely custom tailored, we will walk you through some basic steps. Firstly, if you haven't already, you can create a new 3D view easiest by clicking the button in the Quick toolbar at the top. Now, ask yourself if you want to export the entire model or maybe only a section of it. If the task at hand only targets a small portion of the building, like a room or specific area, it might make sense to limit the view to that area. Also, consider if you need all model information, or only a specific group of elements, like HVAC or doors. These elements can be set visible or invisible with the Visibility Overrides tab, reachable easily by tapping VV on your keyboard. You can then select the categories you wish to show or hide, unfolding the menus for detailed control. Even though Gamma AR only requires at least one wall, space, or column to be exported, as a general rule of thumb, it makes sense to have at least some, if not all, load-bearing architectural elements visible. This makes it a lot easier to position yourself later on, as well as being able to ascertain the location of the planned 3D model information in respect to the environment being built on site.
Additionally, best practice for Gamma AR is that all objects should be associated with reference levels or building stories. Depending on the level of development of your project, it is highly advised that simplicity is ensured by avoiding multiple building stories per floor. If you have multiple reference levels per floor, as for example structural slabs as well as floor finishing, Gamma AR best practice is to define the top of structural slabs as building stories.
There are a few settings that need to be specifically chosen for Gamma AR to work optimally. We will now show you how to set them up and save the configuration. If you haven't already, the first thing you need to set up in the IFC options is to exclude the areas from the export. We will do this by clicking on File, navigating to Options, and opening IFC Options. In the new dialog, we can scroll down to Areas and make sure that they are set to Not Exported. Then, we can close the dialog by clicking on OK. In order to export an IFC, we go back to the File menu and click on Export, moving on to IFC and selecting it. In the newly opened IFC Export dialog, we can either select a pre-configured setup from the drop-down menu, or click on the button to the right of it in order to set the configuration manually. You can configure the in-session setup once, but as we will want to frequently use the export function in order to use the Gamma AR app, we will start by creating a new setup and naming it accordingly. Then, in the Additional Content tab, we check the boxes Only Elements Visible in View, as well as Export Rooms, Areas, and Spaces in 3D Views. In the Property Sets tab, we check Export Revit Property Sets and make sure that Export IFC Common Properties is checked as well. You can control the level of detail of the exported IFC model by setting it in the Level of Detail tab. This overrides the LOD settings at the bottom of the view screen for some more complex geometry. In the Advanced tab, you can store the IFC Globally Unique Identifier, or GUID, as a parameter by checking the respective box. This appends the same IFC GUID as a parameter to the objects within the Revit file. In order to save the configuration, to be able to share it with other users, we can click on the Save Selected Setup icon and save this configuration wherever we like. Once that is done, we close the Modify Setup dialog by clicking on OK. We can save the IFC to a location of our choosing by setting a path in the file name or browsing to its location. Once that's set, we make sure the correct configuration is chosen and press Export. The exported IFC can now be uploaded to Gamma AR.
In order to import your IFCs directly to the Gamma BIM platform, navigate to the Gamma AR portal. Be sure to connect to the correct portal, US or EU, and sign in with your account. Next, select the project you wish to upload the models to from the drop-down menu at the top. When selected, open the Models tab under Projects on the left. If you can only see icons, you can either hover above them or also unfold the panel by clicking on the arrow. Here, you can click on Add Models, and in the new dialog to the left, you can drag and drop your IFC models from your file browser directly into Gamma. Gamma will upload the models automatically, and once the upload is finished, you can close the dialog. You might notice a small turning icon in the model browser of the platform. This shows that Gamma is currently still converting the IFC. The duration of the conversion is dependent on the complexity and size of the individual IFC. Once the spinning icon is gone, the model is ready to be used in the Gamma AR app.
We hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. For more information or help, feel free to visit www.gamma-ar.com.